And scientifically, do you know of any correlation between the presence or absence of bruising on autopsy and the forces necessary to restrict breathing?
No, they're totally different because it's in terms of static forces and dynamic.
What about low oxygen? If somebody has suffers or dies from low oxygen,
Yes.
does that show up on autopsy?
No, it does not.
And the fact that it doesn't, does that mean anything to you whatsoever?
It has no meaning.
And why not?
Because low oxygen is a functional thing, just like an arrhythmia is a functional thing. It doesn't leave a fingerprint on the autopsy. It's just there. It's something that happened. But it won't leave any fingerprint afterwards. You don't see it.
But does it mean that the person didn't die from low oxygen?
No, absolutely not. So if you take somebody and you suffocate him with a pillow, and it's very clear to you after you suffocated the person and he's dead from the pillow, you're not going to see the effects of the low oxygen.
Now, you were asked quite a few questions about Mr. Floyd's pre-existing health conditions.
Correct.
And remember, he cited a number of those.
Yes.
Do any of those conditions have anything to do with the cause of Mr. Floyd's death, in your professional opinion, whatsoever?
None whatsoever.
And again, what was the cause such that those conditions don't matter?
The cause of death is a low level of oxygen that caused the brain damage and caused the heart to stop.
You were also asked questions about substances in Mr. Floyd's system. I think you were asked questions about nicotine. Remember that?
Yes.
He didn't die from nicotine, did he?
No.
You were asked questions about fentanyl and meth.
Yes.
Any evidence that he died from meth?
No, none.
You were asked questions about whether he had ingested any fentanyl within 5 minutes of his time of death.
Yes.
Now, I think you explained to us that if somebody is suffering from a fentanyl overdose, you would see a depression in the respiratory system.
Yes.
And depression means some reduction in the rate or ability to breathe.
Correct.
Did you see any depression in Mr. Floyd's ability to breathe whatsoever before he went unconscious?
No, absolutely not.
Any
It was normal respiratory rate.
evidence then that any fentanyl in his system depressed his breathing in any way whatsoever?
No, and that's further borne out in the carbon dioxide.